Hi everyone, welcome back to Cabin Creek Homestead. This is Scott again with another video. It is officially October and I love the holidays. October 1st through December 31st is my favorite time of the year. All right, yours too apparently. And I'm a stickler when it comes to holidays. Like, I don't want to cheapen the holiday by celebrating it at another time. So I don't really do anything pumpkin until October. I just think it's the best time. I like associating things with holidays. So like pumpkin spice latte doesn't happen until September. Pumpkins and jack-o'-lanterns don't happen until October. Christmas movies and Christmas stuff doesn't happen until after Thanksgiving. I can be a stickler about that. My kids laugh at me, but it is now officially October, and I went and bought this massive pumpkin at Sam's, and I'm sure you've seen those viral videos where the chickens will carve a pumpkin, will kind of carve a jack-o'-lantern. The first one I saw, and I think the godmother, if you will, of that trend was, I don't even know her name, but it's Breelis or Breelis, B-R-E-E-L-L-I-S, I think. Hers was the first one I saw, and it's the one that's got, I think, millions of views. It's amazing. And then, of course, since then, lots of other farmers have tried it to varying degrees of success. But we're going to try it here at Cabin Creek. I figured my wife, Christine, is known as the chicken lady around here, which, another sidebar, be on the lookout for an upcoming video. The local county 4-H asked Christine to provide, I think, all the chicks for, or all the eggs for their second grade hatching program. I think it was like 12 dozen eggs. So we're going to be getting that many chicks, which... I'm not a math major, but I think that's 144 chicks. So they're going to be coming to the homestead soon. And that's going to be in addition to the 60-something we already have. So, hey, duckies. Y'all saw the ducks just leave. There comes a rooster right now. Ha. Anyway, so I figured we have a chicken lady here locally, my wife, and we have a homestead. So why not try this out here? So I got this pumpkin. I'm gonna do what she did in the video, but first I'm gonna cut out the hole and I'm gonna dig out all the guts. So if it works, we can light it like she did and make an actual jack-o'-lantern. So without further ado, here we go. The chicken carving pumpkin experiment here at Cabin Creek. All right, so I got my lid cut. It fits on perfectly. I've got the inside scooped out, nice and clean. Now, I believe in the video with that lady, what she did was she just basically found a side of the pumpkin that was pretty. So I'm gonna check that out real quick. I gotta figure out what side I wanna do this on. But you kinda figure out, there you go, where, you know, what looks good, which I think, this is the bad side of the pumpkin, so I think I'm just going to do right here. All right, so you find what side of the pumpkin you like, and then she basically just scraped, took like a knife or something and scraped out eyes and a mouth. So that's just what I'm going to do. All right, so I got it kind of carved out. It's about, you know, got some eyes and a mouth. It's not clean, but it's, I can clean it up. It's gonna get messy in the coop. So We're gonna do it like this. I'm gonna go ahead and put the lid on it, and let's go put it in and see what happens.
All right, so it looks like they're very wary of it at first. I don't think a single chicken has actually started pecking at it yet, but they're getting very close. As you can see, they're very interested in it. There they go. There they go. Look at that one right there on the right. He's pecking, look, boom. So it's been about an hour and we're coming in to check on it. They've already gotten through the left eye and the mouth, as you can see. They've already gotten through it. It's pretty good, looking pretty good. It's been about an hour, so we'll update you in a little bit. Well, welcome back. This is day two of our chicken pumpkin carving experiment. And this is what we came up with after day one. Or after the first try, I should say. So we put this bad boy in there. You saw the video of them pecking it out. It's actually not that bad. It's kind of got a little pirate, kind of a lip curl into the eye kind of thing. Like, I'm not mad at it. I'm not mad at it. We're going to use it. I think we can still put a candle in there and it'll be a hilarious decoration. But I don't understand what happened here. Somehow they pecked the back of it, which you, like, again, you probably saw in the video. They made a nice little hole in the back there. Maybe it's exhaust for the pumpkin. I'm not sure. But I did learn a couple things. One, if there's any kind of a way for them to be able to connect, like they're gonna peck bigger than you cut. Like, I didn't cut this big. They made it bigger. You know, I don't know. I think I left it in there too long is ultimately what I did. I left it in there. I had to go to work and I left pretty much all day. There was an hour of a time frame where they had already broken through the inner wall, and then I left it for a whole day. Or the rest of the day. I think I left it in there too long. So, I like this, but I think we can do better. So, I bought another pumpkin, brand new, and I'm gonna try it again. I think we can do better. So, part two commence now. All right, we're ready for part two. I got my eyes cut out. I got my mouth cut out. I try to keep them separate, a little bit further apart, and a little bit smaller. So let's go put it in and see what happens. Right, it has been an hour, so I'm gonna come over here and just see how we're looking. All right, that hole was looking good, maybe too good. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn this thing on its side, like that. see if they start digging at the top where the mouth is. There you go. That's what I'm looking at. See, maybe that'll...
Alright, well, it looks like I saved it just in time. It was about to get too big of an eye there, and this right here was about to get connected, but I pulled it out after about 2 hours, and we have a very, very, very nice looking pumpkin. A little bit weird with the eye there, but overall, good job, chickens. Let me go put some candles in it, and we'll see. All right, well, I think this was a success. They don't look perfect. They don't look store-bought or anything, but fun little project letting the chickens carve out our pumpkins. They look great at night, I think, with some other decorations around them. So thanks for tuning in. So chickens can carve your pumpkin for you. That's what we learned today. Thanks.